Hello friends, I am NK Jain from Skill on Tech. In the series of top 200 pump interview questions, I am presenting part 4 of 20, question 31 to 40. In this video, we shall discuss about gland packings, which are widely used in industries for valves and pumps. The video covers uses of gland packings, their materials, selection, installation, and other aspects which are essential to know for use of gland packings. What are the uses of gland packings? Gland packings are used for sealing in the following applications: stationary applications like tanks, hatch cover sealing, manhole cover sealing, etc. Used for reducing leakage along the stem in globe wall, gate wall, and ball valve. You can see a picture here where in this gate wall you can see this gland packing is provided here along the stem. Used for reducing leakage of the working fluid in reciprocating pumps. Used for reducing leakage of the working fluid in rotating pumps like centrifugal pumps and screwed gear pumps. You can see a picture of a split casing pump where these gland packings are shown here. In propeller shaft sealing, in lifeboats and old generations of merchant ships, these gland packings are also used for preventing leakages. What are the common material of gland packing in pumps? You can see a picture of a gland packing rope which is shown. Gland packings are made from the following basic substances and are a combination of these basic materials and are sometimes reinforced with metal wires for extreme conditions such as high pressure and temperatures. So, what are the common materials? Jute, flax, hemp, cotton, PTFE, polytetrafluoroethylene, aramid, wrapped metal foils, graphite fibers. So, these are the general materials which are used for gland packings. Various styles are available for braiding of packing with various combination of materials. So you can refer a catalog of manufacturer for different kind of styles and their different braidings. What are the checkpoints to install gland packings? The trueness of the shaft. You can see a picture here where the shaft is shown and this is a housing. These are the gland packings. This is a gland follower and this is a bolt which is tightened in the stuffing box housing and a gland follower. This bolt is used to tighten the gland follower to give a tightness to the gland packings. A shaft that is bent would eat the gland packing prematurely and there nothing you can do except change the shaft. You must make it a point to check the trueness of the shaft during each overhaul using a dial gauge. So what you can do, you can put a shaft in a V block and provide a dial gauge and then you rotate the shaft and check the trueness of the shaft whether it is a bent or not. If your shaft is bent, then you have to replace it, otherwise you have to remove the bend from the shaft, otherwise your gland packing will worn out very fast. Concentricity of the shaft with the swing box bore. The shaft might be true, but if not aligned properly would again destroy the gland packing in no time. So the axis of the shaft and axis of the stiffing box housing shall be concentric. Surface roughness of the shaft. If the shaft or the sleeve is pitted or unevenly worn, it would again damage the gland packing very fast. So generally what you can see, there may be a shaft sleeve over the shaft and gland packings are provided over the shaft sleeve. If your shaft sleeve is pitted, then it will also damage the gland packings very fast. So the shaft sleeve should be smooth and perfect. Whipping of the shaft due to worn bearings. If your bearings are worn out, then also your shaft may not rotate perfectly in the center. So that may also cause to worn out of gland packings. Consistent cooling water supply in case of pump with a lanterning. If lanterning is provided in the gland packings, then a continuous cooling water supply is required to provide cooling to the gland packings. Due to friction, gland packings got heated, and due to high temperature rise, gland packings may damage very fast. How to remove and install gland packings? You can see a picture of a gland extractor here. Removing a gland packing can be very tough sometimes, especially if it is old and well set. You need to have specially contoured tools. Gland packing extractors are available to remove gland packings and same shall be used. They just have to be twisted to get a grip and then the packing can be pulled out. Sometimes we used to open a suction valve to provide a back pressure to the stuffing box to remove the gland packings. So that idea can also be used if you are finding it difficult to remove the gland packings. How to install gland packing in valve or pump? First of all, remove all the old packings and clean stiffing box and shaft thoroughly. Examine shaft or sleeve for wear or scoring. Replace shaft or sleeve if wear is excessive. Use the correct cross section of packing or die forming rings. To determine the correct packing size, measure the diameter of the shaft inside the stiffing box area if possible, and then measure the diameter of the stiffing box to give the OD of the ring. Subtract the ID measurement from the OD measurement and divide by 2. This will give you size of the gland packing. When using coil or spiral packing, always cut the packing into separate rings. Install gland packing of correct length. Install one ring at a time. After the last ring is installed, take a bolt's finger tight or slightly snugged up. And then finally, you tied the gland follower bolts by spanner. Allow packing to leak freely when starting up a newly packed pump. So, in the starting of the pump, we shall allow some water to leak from the stuffing box to provide cooling to the gland packings and to them well set. So, when once it is set and there is no smoke from the gland packings, then slightly we can tighten the gland follower bolts and we can set the gland packings. Provide means of lubricating the shaft and packing through the lantern ring by supplying water, oil, grease or liquid handled in the pump. So, gland packing shall be provided a cooling and lubrication. So, this cooling can be provided through a lantern ring or otherwise we may allow a small water to leak from the stiffing box. How to select gland packing for different applications? An incorrectly selected gland packing would soon fail in service and lead to leakages, and that may hamper your production losses. Selection of correct gland packing is must for an engineer, so we shall select the gland packings as per OEM recommendation. For water and air, lubricated and graphite packings are generally used. For steam, high pressure and temperature, lubricated and graphite reinforced with metal packings are used. Oil and gas, chemical, acid, alkali, etc. Fluorocarbon fiber, interbraided packings, PTFE, PTFE duplex braided, graphite bonded fluoropolymer, fiber packings, duplex braided and expanded graphite packings are used. So there is a various styles are available of gland packings with various combination of braidings. So we shall refer the manufacturer's catalog for selection of gland packing for particular application. What are the selection criteria for gland packings? Chemical resistance or pH level. This is very important because if your media which is used in the handled by the pump is having a low pH, then we shall choose the correct gland packing, otherwise it will damage very fast. Shaft linear speed, pressure in the flow system, temperature and what kind of fluid that is handled by the pump. So these are some important points to selection of gland packings. How to cut gland packing correctly? You can see two pictures here. This is a butt joint which is shown here, and this is a skew joint where this is gland packing, this is cut in the 45 degree. The gland packing should be cut with a sharp knife to avoid fraying of the edges. Do not use scissors or hacksaw blade, etc. A heavy duty engineer knife or sharpened ordinary knife would serve the purpose for cutting of the gland packing. There are two different methods of cutting the gland packing. The first one is a straight or at 90 degree, that is butt joint, which is shown in the picture. And the second one is a 45 degree, that is skew joint. The 45 degree method gives better sealing result and preferred. A skilled oriented job and the angle on both the ends should match properly, otherwise it would lead to leakage. So while cutting the gland packing and when installing the gland packings in the stuffing box, a proper and skilled work shall be carried out, otherwise your gland packing can leak excessively. Your pump gland packing is leaking frequently. How you will troubleshoot? You can see a picture here where you can see a gland packing is seen. This is a gland follower and this is a stuffing box. Gland packing rings torn out, replace the packing. If your gland packing rings are torn out, worn out or damaged, then you completely replace the packings. Gland packing may be of undersize. If your gland packing is of undersize, then select the suitable size of packing. Gland packing quality, material not appropriate. Select suitable packing with respect to pressure and temperature, shaft speed. Shaft sleeve may have pittings that may also cause for damage to gland packings. Then replace shaft sleeve or machine it prior to installation of gland packings. A stuffing box ID may be checked for corrosion, erosion. Due to corrosive media handling through a pump, a stuffing box may got corroded from inside of bore. So that stuffing box, if it is corroded, then corrective action shall be taken for stuffing box corrosion, erosion, and if required, replace the housing. So these are some important points. If your gland packing is leaking, then you have to check all these following points and take corrective action accordingly. What is advantage of gland packing over mechanical seal? So gland packings are also having advantage over mechanical seal. Mechanical seal having its own advantage, but gland packings are also having advantage over mechanical seal. It is an extremely reliable sealing method and simple to install and maintain with respect to mechanical seal. It tolerates poor mechanical conditions like off-center shaft and worn down anti-friction bearings better than mechanical seals. Works better in abrasive media and corrosive environments than mechanical seal. They are less expensive, economical than mechanical seal. Reduce the stock holding as one size packing can be used in all similar sized pumps. It is very cost effective in downtime as very little time is required to change a gland packing. As little as 15 minutes, we can finish the job of replacement of gland packing. The whole pump is not required to be opened for changing the gland packing. However, in mechanical seal, the pump has to be opened up. The gland packings are not fragile and any amount of mishandling would not destroy them, unlike the mechanical seal. So these are some advantages of gland packing over mechanical seal. What is a stuffing box and purpose of lantern ring in a stuffing box? The stuffing box assembly consists of five major components. They are stuffing box casing, stuffing box bushing or throat bush, packing rings, packing gland or gland follower, lantern ring. All the components shall intact and internal surfaces shall be checked for corrosion and erosion. We shall see the picture of a stuffing box in the next slide. You can see a picture here of a stuffing box where you can see a lantern ring is shown here. This. And this is a sealing liquid connection for providing cooling to gland packings here. A lantern ring is an annular ring with channels for the passage of water that is inserted between the gland packings. So this lantern ring is in the middle of gland packings. Half the gland packings are this side and half of the gland packings in the this side. So half gland packings are in the outward and half in the inward. Fluid is fed from an external pipe to the lantern ring for lubrication and the cooling of the packing. So you can see this picture. This liquid or water is fed through this connection to the lantern ring, and through lantern ring this cooling water goes to the gland packings for providing cooling. It is used in applications where a number of packings are there and it would be difficult of the intermediate packing to get fluid for lubrication. So therefore this lantern ring will provide lubrication to all gland packings and cooling also. It is also used where the fluid to be sealed is contaminated with abrasive or is corrosive and a clean fluid is required for lubrication. While installation, it is crucial that the holes in the lantern ring meet or are aligned with the holes in the pipes. It is very important to inspect and align the lantern ring during each overhaul of the pump. So these are some important points for lantern ring. Thanks for watching the video. If you like this video, hit like button below. Share it with your friends and colleagues. Subscribe our channel for getting updates on upcoming videos. Please leave any comments, feedback to improve the videos. Thank you.